Hi, it's Karin Lanning from the YMCA of Greater Michiana at the O'Brien Center. It's so nice to see you this morning for some yoga. We're going to just need our mats. We're going to work on some hip stretches and releasing some tension through the lower back. As always, please listen to your bodies. If something doesn't feel good, go to a pose that you know is comfortable for you. Otherwise, let's get started on our mats. And let me grab the mic so you can really hear me. So go ahead and get yourself situated.
Then we're going to start off in child's pose with knees wide, engage that core, toes are together in the back, and we're just going to walk it forward. So go ahead and ease your body down to the floor. We're going to take this time just to let the upper body rest. As our forehead is resting on the floor, we relax the shoulders with the exhale. Take that slow breath in. And just begin to think about what your goal is for today's practice. Sometimes we come to yoga needing something in particular. And although I'm not with you, I want you to decide what it is you need this morning. Do each of the movements with an intention. So that at the end of the practice, your goal is met. Through whatever poses we move through today. Bring awareness to the shoulders. Do you want to take the elbows a little bit wider if there is pressure in the shoulders? Can you shift those hips just slightly to allow the tailbone to come towards the heels? And then take a slow inhale again. As you exhale, let the body soften towards the mat. Taking the breath in and exhaling, releasing tension. Take a little inhale, lift the chest slightly. We're going to take the right arm and tuck it underneath the left arm. And bring that right shoulder and ear towards the floor. And then just square those hips again so we find the shoulder stretch. And just beginning to bring awareness to what the body is feeling. Letting the body soften towards the mat with the exhale. And trying to release the work of holding the pose so that the body settles. Next inhale, lift up the body. Right arm stretches forward, left arm tucks under. And left shoulder and ear rest gently towards the floor. And again, we just see if we can relax the tension in the shoulders. Letting the hips settle. And then really releasing any muscle work that's happening. This is your chance for your body to just rest and breathe. And recover. So that is tight. Inhale, lift the chest. And then we're going to ease the body forward, coming into horse stance. So tuck those knees underneath the hip bones, hands underneath the shoulders. Roll those shoulders back and down. And let's just take an inhale. Let the belly button drop towards the floor. And inhale, lifting the head up. And And then exhale, pull the spine up towards the ceiling, rounding the back and letting the head drop as you exhale. Just slowly bringing that movement to the spine, inhaling. And exhaling. And you can focus that breath through your inhale. Imagine that you're right in front of the mirror and you're going to exhale. And let that breath be warm so that it fogs up the mirror. You might feel and hear that breath moving through the open mouth. One more time, moving through. And then we're going to shift the weight onto the left hand and the right knee. Start to slide that right hand forward and the left leg back. So I want you to anchor the body. Come to this initial position here where the hand and foot are still on the floor. And then when you're ready, take an inhale and lift the arm and leg up, squeezing and reaching. The back is flat, the glutes are squeezed tight. And we're holding this, but breathing. So the body is working, the mind and the breath still focused. And release. And we're going to shift to the other side. So just start to shift the other hand and foot. Make sure that the core is engaged, belly button pulls up to the spine. And then we shift and lift. And here we breathe, inhaling slowly. And exhaling. One more breath in. And releasing. Shifting, pulling right up if you want. Squeezing, bracing. It's a nice extension to warm up the back of our bodies. Hand comes right back underneath the shoulder, knee underneath the hip to help us anchor and level out of the back. And then one more time, each side, inhaling up, squeezing, reaching. Eye gaze is on the floor to help keep the spine in alignment. Releasing. And then one last time on the side. And release. Take the knees wide. And just sit back. Find that child's pose. Stretch. Shoulders relaxed. If you want, touch that forehead down. And then brace the core. We're going to lift up. And then we're going to crouch in. So the chest comes low. Brace the core and shift up into that little baby cobra. Elbows tucked in, core tight. Good. Exhale, press back in to that little child's pose. Good. And again, inhaling, scooping the chest down low, squeezing the bottom of the shoulder blades. Finding that baby cobra. And we work back through. We're going to add just a little turn with this, so brace, scoop down low, and when you come here, just take a look over that right shoulder, still squeezing the bum, bracing the core, inch it back, breathing, and pulling through, chest low, shoulders back, exhale. Turning, looking over that left shoulder, bum squeeze tight, inhaling back to center, and exhaling back to relax. So we warm up the back of our body. We should have felt that warmth through the shoulders. Now inhale, Then take the hands, spread the fingers wide, tuck the toes under, brace your core, inhale and then exhale back into our first down dog. And we're just going to pedal the feet. So if we get a little dizzy with the head down, take that eye gaze toward the fingertips. As we just pedal those feet, seeing how the legs are feeling. And we're going to walk the feet in, keeping our knees bent, eye gaze looking forward to forward fold. Hands come to the shins. Inhale, flatten the back and pull those elbows into our flat back. Inhale, and then exhale, bend the knees, hands come down. And we're going to do a slow roll all the way to standing. While we inhale, squeeze the glutes, brace the core. And exhale, fold again. Core tight, knees bending. Hands reaching the floor. Let the head hang if that feels good for you. Inhale to flat back extension. The crown of the head is reaching forward. And exhale to forward fold. Knees bent, core tight. Inhale, bring it up. And exhale, fold. One last time. Come to that flat back extension. Inhaling, hands to shin. And exhaling, bending the knees and rolling all the way up. Coming here, extending the hands up, squeezing the bum, and just open the chest and the eye gaze up to the ceiling. And slowly release. Let's take those feet nice and wide. We're going to turn the right toe and point it to the right wall. Left toe is pointing forward, and the heel of that right foot should intersect where the arch of the left foot is. Bend that knee right over the ankle. And let's inhale, arms long. Square the hips and the shoulders. Eye gaze looking over that right hand. Now we're going to keep those arms level. And we're going to breathe it forward. Squeeze the glutes and breathe it back. So we're trying to keep those arms level, reaching. And then pulling back, squeezing the glutes. Again, reach. Good. Press into that long, straight left leg. One more time. Reach. Pulling back, squeezing those glutes. And this time we're going to reach and let that right arm tuck down to the thigh. Left arm reaches over. Square the hips and shoulders to the front. And press into that long leg. So you're feeling that warmth through the legs. Belly button is tight. I'm going to just breathe the chest out. Keep the right knee bent as we find Sun Warrior. And we're going to flow between those two. Big reach. If you're looking for a little bit more work, you can take that right hand down, fingertips to the floor if you want. I'm not looking for that work today. So just make sure you're following what you need for your body. One more time, extend your warrior. And exhale, squeeze the glutes, coming back up to that Sun Warrior. And then inhale, straighten that right leg. Arms long and strong, core engaged, glutes squeezed. Reach that right arm forward. And then gently let that right hand drop to the leg to find triangle. And we square the hips and shoulders to the front of the room. Once they're there, let's relax the shoulders. If you're looking for more work, press the feet into the floor, lift, and take that hand off. Stay there and breathe if you want. One more time, brace the core, bend that right knee, and press lift. You can shake out those hips, and we're going to switch it over to the other side. So left toe points to the left wall, right leg long. Left knee bends, hips and shoulders square. Inhale, reach those arms long. Exhale, let the fingertips extend. Good. Knee stays over that ankle, and we're going to breathe it forward. Squeeze the glutes and back. as we reach, squeezing just a little tightness back there as we're squeezing those glutes. And then one more time. When you're ready, tuck that left arm, reach that right arm over, open the chest, brace the core, keep the legs right there. Inhale, lift it, and exhale, release. Again, inhale, flowing back down to a steady warrior, reaching that right arm, bracing the core, squeezing the glutes, lifting the spine, and exhaling. Good. Just flowing through. Smooth and steady, inhaling, exhaling, and then open the arms, straighten that left leg, brace the core, we're going to reach, and then softly drop in, turn the body towards the front, so arms are reaching long, inner thighs are squeezing, legs pressing evenly into both legs. If you want, remember you can take that hand off. Beautiful. Brace the core, bend the knee, press and lift. And shake those hips. We're going to work a little bit of balance. So I like to work balance off the mat. I do like two mats, so it's a little extra squishy for my knees, but not so great on balance. So do what's right for you. We're going to take the right foot and put all of the weight into that right leg. There's a slight bend. Hands are going to come to the hips, and we're going to find great posture up top, bracing the core. Take that left leg and start to slide it back as we tip forward. Now, you might decide that right here is far enough for today. If you want a little bit more, start to lean and lift that leg and back. Now, we're going to square those hips towards the ground. And you might even lift that leg up in line with the upper body. Brace the core, inhale, reach those arms forward. Should feel like intense work for that right leg. And then reach those hands back. We're going to do a little dive, lifting that leg. Oh, it's a challenge. And release. Shake it loose. All right, let's come to the other side. So weights in that left leg. Hands on the hips. Shoulders roll back and down. Brace the core. There's that slight bend in the left knee, and we're going to slide that right foot back. Keep that knee open towards the pinky toe, engaging that glute medius. And when you're ready, lift that leg. Or keep that toe on the ground, level up the hips. Inhale, reach the arms forward, big stretch. And then sweep the hands behind. Maybe letting that head drop and extend and release. Sometimes we have good sides and bad sides. Shake those legs. We're going to put that weight on the right leg. Find that long spine and then inhale the arms up and come to tree pose so that toe can be on the ground. You might lift that foot up to the calf. If you have that flexibility, you might take that foot to the inner thigh. Core stays tight, brace the core. We're going to extend that leg back. So we're going to come in that same position, but just from tree pose. So extend the body forward, left leg is reaching back. Reach the arms behind, linking the hands, and diving one more time. And releasing, shake it loose. All right, find that long spine. Shift the weight into that left leg. Inhale, arms reach up, so long spine. And then we find tree pose. You're squeezing those glutes. You might lift that foot to the calf, maybe all the way up, you decide. So here's the challenge. Bend that left knee, lean it forward. So we find that challenge in our balance, reaching. When you're ready, hands reach back. And clasp, you can put that toe down, and then extend if you want. Oh boy, those legs are feeling it today. And release, shake it out. Woo! A little more challenge on the standing today. Let's come back to the mat. And just find your forward fold. So knees bent, feet hip distance apart. up ahead, relax. So find a little stretch in that lower back. Belly button is tight. Take the right foot back to the knee and bring the left foot forward so you can help that foot forward. And then open that knee out and bring the hands inside of the foot. Now, if you want, you might walk that foot just a little bit wider, allowing those arms to settle in the front. We're going to work on relaxing that hip. So just settle in here. We're going to be here for a little bit. So I want you to start to relax the hips forward. You can use that left arm on the inside of the left leg and just stretch the outside of those hips. Coming back to that slow breath in. Exhale, we're going to shift the hips back, lifting the front toe and letting the head drop. We change that stretch to the back of that left leg. You decide where you want to go, how low you drop. Take an inhale, bring the hips forward again and settle back into that kneeling lunge. Now we're going to add on, you can repeat and just relax here, or you can turn that left toe out and take the left hand up to the thigh. Inhale to lift the chest and turn it towards that front leg. Now it should intensify that stretch on the outer glute. If you want a little bit more, begin to roll the foot onto the side and you can gently use that arm to twist a little farther towards that front leg. And maybe even letting that right hip drop a little lower towards the ground. So a nice stretch here. Try to relax the shoulders while we're here. Couple more breaths. Remember that deep, warm exhale, releasing tension from the body. One more inhale. Exhale and begin to rotate back to the front. Pivot that toe towards the front, hands come in, hips shift back. Front toe lifts as the head drops gently. And we feel that nice hamstring stretch. And the button is tight, we're going to shift the hips forward and take that left leg back. And right leg comes forward. Help it out if you need to. Just give it a little nudge forward so that the knee is either above or behind the ankle. And then hands to the inside. You can walk that foot out a little wider if you want. But let's work on relaxing those hips down. Even though we have weight in the hands, shoulders are still rolled back and locked down with great posture. As you exhale, shift the hips back, lifting the front toe, letting the head drop. Inhale, shifting the body forward, deciding, do you want to stay there again? Just repeat that. Or turn the toe out, brace the core, and take that right hand up to the thigh. Exhale as you twist the body towards that front leg. And then maybe just roll that foot onto the edge to allow just a little more hip opening. And we breathe here, relaxing the hips towards the floor, keeping the chest lifted and the core engaged. Belly button engaged, untwist the body, hands come down, hips shift back, front toe lifts. Oh, we sink in just a little bit deeper the second time through. Shoulders relaxed. Core pulled in towards the spine to protect the lower back. Race and ease those hips forward. with more intensity, we're gonna ease back and move into frog pose. So it's been a little while since we've done frog pose. I like to roll my mat over, so you're welcome to do that. We're gonna take the knees wide, and then we want the ankles to line up right behind the knees. So it might be hard to tell with my mat, but the toes are pointing towards the front of the room. Ankles behind knees, toes pointing towards you guys. And then you decide, do you want to come down to forearms? Good, nice and easy. This is our frog getting ready to leap. So we're still engaging that core, and you might just need to shift a little to find just the right spot. Anytime you need a little breather, you just ease forward, and then when you're ready, you can just exhale back in a little bit deeper. So upper body engaged but relaxed, core softly engaged towards the spine. Now, once you take an inhale, you're going to squeeze your inner thighs. Those adductor muscles are going to squeeze tight and hold everything tight. And then exhale, soften and release the tension in the legs. You might feel that you drop in just a little bit deeper. Again, inhale, squeeze those inner thighs, everything tight. Exhale and completely release the tension with those hips soften. And inhale, brace, squeeze. And last time, exhale. And release into that frog pose. And we're going to shift the body weight forward and just tuck the toes towards each other. Send the hips back. You might bring those knees in just a little bit. And we're going to settle here for just a moment in our wide knee child's pose. So reset. We've been focusing on movements. Bring your mind back to the beginning of class when we talked about what you needed for class today. We've got these big hip openers. We're going to work out of that with some twists to release tension through the spine. So refocus on your goal. Take an inhale, shift the body forward. Hands underneath shoulders. Brace your core and bring those knees in and set back. So you can unravel the mat if you went there. And we're going to take our legs over to your left side. Just scooch the hips, straighten the legs, and we're going to just ease those hips back. So we want to find this really straight spine here. You can bend the knees as needed, but you're going to pull the core in tight. We're going to inhale, reaching those arms up, and exhale, fold it forward. Knees bend as needed, hands come down. And we're keeping that straight spine, so we're not trying to fold over to our legs. We're really trying to stretch those hamstrings, keeping the back straight, the chest lifted. So sometimes we're tight in the lower back because our hamstrings are tight, so we're going to loosen those up first before we ask the back to do more. Inhale, walk the hands back, come into that long lifted spine. Take your right leg, tuck it in towards the left inner thigh, and we're going to take that left hand to the inner thigh, open the chest up, and exhale over. So we're working on trying to pull this bottom shoulder forward to open the chest, and you feel a stretch down the right side of the body, getting into those right obliques. And then release. Come back, straighten the legs, adjust those hips as needed, brace the core, inhale it up. Exhale, keep that strong, straight back, and let those hands softly come to the floor. So we're looking forward, keeping the core tight to keep the lower back safe. And then bracing the core, walking the hands back. We're going to come to the other side. So the same thing repeats on the other side. Left foot in towards the inner thigh. Right hand to the inside of the right leg. Inhale, you're going to open up away from the picture. And exhale as you stretch. Remember, we want to push that bottom shoulder forward to open the chest. So we're focusing more on the lowest shoulder to allow the upper shoulder to stretch, getting into that left side of the body. And then releasing, bracing. One last time, legs straight. You need to adjust those hips. Big inhale up. And exhale, reach as far forward as you can. Maybe just a little bit farther this time, still with a straight back. So your shoulders are pulled back and down. Eye gaze is looking just past those toes. Feeling those hamstrings stretch. Might even be getting down to those calf muscles. All right, brace the core, walk the hands back. And put the soles of the feet on the floor. Pick the hips up, shift them forward. And then roll down, nice and easy. And take just a moment here. See how the spine is feeling on the floor. Let the belly button relax towards the spine. And then knees are still up. So we're going to take that right leg, bring it up and over the left leg. And the hands are going to come out wide, palms down in a T position. Brace your core, press into your left foot to lift your hips up. Take the hips over to that right side and set them back down. Now this right knee is going to pull over towards the left side of the body. So we stretched a little bit of that side. Now we're getting in a little bit deeper. So we're going to take our time until we can let the legs relax. So find that position where you can not hold the legs in position. Even if that means it's higher, so that you can relax the shoulders. And really let the side of the body stretch and relax. And here for a few breaths, so if you want to close your eyes, take that slow breath in, and exhale. And if you need to deepen that twist, take the left hand to the outside of the right thigh and just apply gentle pressure. Even just the weight of your hand is enough to deepen that twist slightly. Still breathing slow. And then when you're ready, hold that in super tight. Brace the core as you lift the legs up. Keep the legs right as they are. Push into that left foot, lift the hips up, and straighten the spine as you release the hips back to the floor. And then we're going to let the legs float to that right side. So you're bracing your core while you move. That keeps us safe. When your body says that's far enough, we stop. And then you focus on the breath. Just feeling the stretch now on the opposite side. Letting the shoulders soften. So they're resting evenly into the floor. And feeling that big stretch. Lower back. Obliques. Knees, muscles, IT band. Depending on where your legs are, you can hit a few different spots. When you're ready, brace that core. Take an inhale, bring the legs back up. And then take that right foot off. Straighten the hips back up one more time here, relaxing. Taking a slow breath in, exhaling. Now we move to the other side. So left leg comes up and over the right leg. Raise the core, press into the right foot to lift the hips up. Shift them over to the left side, set them back down. That left knee is pulling over to the right side. We're still bracing our core as we move. Finding that spot to relax. And then beginning to breathe and let the body soften. So it becomes less about getting into and holding the pose. Brace the core, inhale, legs come up, legs stay twisted, we're going to pick the hips up, re-center the spine, and then let the legs float over to that left side. Might not go as far, that's okay. Find that spot where the body says enough, and then soften and release tension. That's needed so it feels good in your body. Reverse the core, squeeze, inhale, lift it up. Take that left leg off, lift the hips up, recenter, and then brace the core. We're going to pull those knees in for a little hug. You can rock a little side to side. Our button is tight. Hold on to the knees. We're going to circle the knees. We're going to go four times one direction. Working that breath. One more time. And then back the other direction. Just letting the body release tension as we breathe. And then we're going to use those legs to lock up. Raise the core. Up. We're going to get some deep quad and hip openers. So you might come into 90-90. We're going to square the hips and shoulders and lean in. If you want a little bit different pose, go ahead and take that left leg back and shift the hips up and over for swan pose. Hands can still walk forward, either pose, that's fine. We're going to find this position first and then relax into the pose. Maybe shifting those elbows a little bit wider so the shoulders aren't working to hold the upper body weight. And then shifting the hips around so they're right above the heel. And then maybe playing with a little forward and back or side to side to find just the right spot that you need to stretch. You're welcome to stay here. If you'd like to move into a little more intense stretch, take the body up, brace the core, shift the hips to the side. If you're in that 90-90 position, you can reach right here and stay right here. If you want, you roll the hip back over. It gets a little bit more intense. We're pulling that heel towards the bum, letting the hips shift down, finding that nice stretch. So big quad stretch here. If you want a little bit more ease forward, letting that head rest, letting the hips soften. You might even reach for a full swan, both hands come back, forehead just resting. Just go where your body wants to today. Brace the core, softly release that left foot, hands come down. Inhale, press and come back to down dog. And let's pedal those legs. Eye gaze can look forward. Little release of any tension that built up there. Brace the core. This time we're going to bring that left leg forward. You can come right into that extended swan. You can shift the hips over and come into 90-90. And then work forward. Whatever works for your body today. I'm going to find my extended swan. And we're all going to just relax the hips. Relax the shoulders. And find that deep breath in and exhale, release tension in the hips. Still breathing, smooth and slow. And if you want that intense quad stretch, hands come back, core engaged, lifting the chest. Remember, we're going to set the hips back and just reach for that back leg. So you might just stay here. Each side is different. If you want, you might roll that hip up and over, and you might extend. And remember, all of our bodies are a little bit different, so be patient with yours. I'm being patient with mine as well. If you want, reach that hand back, letting that quad stretch. Shoulders trying to relax while we work here. This side is my hard side. Maybe it is for you. Just be patient with yourself. And then softly release that foot. Inhale. We're going to breathe back into that down dog, letting the heels pedal, shifting those hips up. Remember, eye gaze forward if you tend to get a little dizzy with the head down. And then bring those knees in. We find our core stance. I'm going to set back here. You're going to tuck those toes under. Sometimes we don't get those calf muscles stretched. We're going to just ease back. And this might be enough. But let's open up the chest and shoulders. If you're looking for a little bit more, you might shift those hands back towards the heels. And if you're looking for even more, you might squeeze the bum and stretch those hips forward. Depends on what you're looking for today. One last stretch here, and release, and we have made it to relaxation and meditation. So let's roll it on down. You can lie flat, you can brace your core, sit upright if you want. I'm going to just roll down for today as we get started. Once you're here, maybe you want to take the soles of the feet and open up those knees, stretching those adductor muscles again. You can inhale the arms up overhead, lengthening the spine. You might even need to just straighten that spine. You might take arms out. So just settle here for a moment. Feel free to close your eyes. Let the body get a little heavy into the mat. And as you take this next breath in, decide, is this the spot? stop that you can settle in for a few minutes. If it isn't, please honor your body and move to any pose that you think will be more comfortable. And then if you're ready, eyes closed, we take a really slow breath in through the nose. And exhale, all of that breath, leave open lips. Okay, inhaling is your chance just to slow and to soften. Eyes, very soft through the eyelids. So even if our eyes are closed, sometimes we can be working to keep those eyelids closed. Just soften the cheeks. Maybe the mouth opens slightly. Begin to bring the focus in to the body. Let that exhale move from the crown of the head all the way down through the spine. Letting it relax the shoulders into the mat, the hips into the mat. Taking that slow breath. And then focus just for a moment on the hips. Are you holding any tension there? Can you squeeze the body tight as you inhale and exhale? Let the body relax even deeper. All tension moving away from the body. And we just take that next breath, thinking appreciatively of what our body has done for us this morning. Exhaling, releasing any tension still lingering in the body. Breathing in. Breathing out. And then when you're ready, just slowly bringing movement back to the fingers and the toes. Maybe moving the wrists and the ankles. Bending the knees as needed. If they were straight, bend them. If they were bent, straighten the legs. Take the opposite position. And then gently rolling over to the right side of the body. Tuck the hands underneath the head. Make a little pillow so that the spine stays in alignment. Letting the body relax here for one more breath. And then pushing up onto that right forearm, lifting the chest slightly. Take an extra breath here. Take your time coming up. And then pushing all the way to any seated position, join me there. Find that long spine, let the shoulders relax. And when you're ready, inhale, breathe the arms up overhead. Exhale, take that right arm forward, reach the left arm back. Standing tall, inhale, breathing the arms up and taking the other exhale to the other side. And then arms all the way up, brace the core, exhale, bring the hands to the heart center. And just wishing you a wonderful day. Thank you for spending a little time with me. Don't forget, you can always come and see us now at our locations, but we'll still have some videos online for you. Thank you so much.